Hi, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and let me welcome you to another Geometry Gem where we're going to learn how to unitize vectors. And unitizing vectors is the process of taking a vector that has whatever direction and orientation in three-dimensional space and creating a new one that has the same direction and the same orientation, but whose magnitude is going to be the unit, or in whichever units you're measuring that. We're going to be implementing this in Grasshopper for Rhino using the C# scripting language. And we're going to do it both the manual way, so I'm going to teach you how to do this from scratch so that you can apply this in any other environment. Or if you're more Rhino inclined, I'm going to teach you how to use the Rhino command to perform that operation automatically, okay? But first, before we do any of this, as usual, let's take a look conceptually at what unitizing a vector is and how the algorithm works. Wonderful. So let's break down the rules for unitizing a vector. So let's say we have any vector in three-dimensional space and that we're going to name that vector v with an arrow. This is a very common way of notating vectors. And then what we're going to do is we're also going to assume that the length of that vector is whatever value. We don't really know, we can find it. It's very easy to compute, but it's whatever value it is. It's probably not the value of one. And I'm going to denote the length of a vector by using these double vertical bars around the vector name. All right, so this expression that you see here means that the length of vector v is whatever, okay? And then what we want to do is from vector v, we want to find a new vector that we're going to call v hat. And the hat is a very common notation for unit vectors. And we want to find a new vector v hat, that has a property, which is that it has the same orientation and the same direction of the original v vector, but the length is going to be one unit in whichever system we're measuring. It doesn't really matter. So we're going to assume we want to find what the coordinates of vector v hat are so that the length of that vector satisfies that it's equal to one. Or in other words, we want to turn vector v into a vector with the same direction and the same magnitude, but just in the same direction, but with only the length of one. How can we do that? Well, if you think about this, you remember that vectors have x and y and z coordinates, whatever those are. I'm doing this diagram in 2D, but everything that I'm explaining will work in 3D the same. And that what we want is to find the coordinates of a new vector in the same direction, but only with a unit length. And if you think about this, turns out that you can see from this diagram that there is a very clear rule of proportionality between the original vector and the unitized vector. So think about this. If the original vector has a magnitude of 2 units, then if you want to find a vector of unit 1, then basically what you have to do is divide each one of the coordinates by 2, right? Or if you have a vector of 5 units long, then what you need to do in order to find the unit vector is divide each one of the coordinates by 5, right? You just need to shrink down those coordinates by a factor of the length. So what that means technically is that in order to find a unit vector v hat from any other vector, what we need to do is we need to take the original vector and we need to divide that vector by the length of such a vector. So whatever the length of this vector is, whatever this vector is, we need to divide it by its own length to find the vector with the same direction, but just one unit length. And what does dividing a vector by a number, what does that mean? Well, what it means practically is to take each one of the coordinates of the vector, and then which are numbers, and divide that coordinate by the length of the vector, and then use those coordinates to assemble the new unit vector. I don't know if I overcomplicated the way I explained this or if the way I notated this on the screen, but long story short, in order to find a unit vector from an original one, the only thing you need to do is take the original vector and divide each one of its coordinates by the length of that vector. And those new coordinates will be the coordinates of a unit vector that has the same direction, the same orientation, but the magnitude is going to be 1. And this is what I've tried to express with maybe a little bit of more mathematical notation that I typically do in this channel, but I think simple mathematical notation is healthy sometimes to be exposed to. Anyway, now let's take a look at how can we do that using writing computer code, okay? Wonderful. So in this case, I'm going to be using Grasshopper for Rhinoceros, which is a visual programming language which already has a geometry kernel. So we already have vector elements, etc., etc. But if you're using a different environment like Unity or whatever, you have very similar capacities here. So what I'm going to do now, what I have here is a Grasshopper definition where I can create a vector from scratch, all right? And then with X, Y, and Z coordinates. And you can see that I'm creating a vector and I'm displaying it anchored at coordinates 0, 0, 0. And then I have taken that vector and I have fed it to another component that takes any vector and unitizes that vector. And you can see that I have here this second vector, which has the same direction, the same orientation, but is 1 unit long. And you can see how the coordinates of this vector are different from the original. And even if I crank it very small, each one of the coordinates, you can see how the vector still actually, you know, and now the vector, the unit vector is actually longer than the original one. Anyway, so what we're going to do is we're going to try to mimic the behavior of this component by writing a C# script component that is going to take 1 vector. I'm going to call this vector in, all right? And I'm going to make sure that this, I'm going to right click, type hint, vector3D, I'm going to make sure that this is of the type vector. And then the output is going to be vout, which is, or v, well, I can do v unit, for example, and this is going to be v, simple v. And then I'm going to plug this in here. I'm going to copy and paste this. And then what I would like to do, oops, sorry, no, I'm going to plug in here. I'm going to take the original vector and I'm going to write here some code that is going to return a new vector with unitized coordinates. So how are we going to do that? It's going to be super easy. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to compute the length of the original vector. All right. And how can I do that? Well, I'm going to create a variable that is going to be called length, and I could do it two ways. So I could do, for example, because I am working in Grasshopper and Rhino, I know that vectors, for example, v, which is the input, we know that vectors have a property that is called length that I can use to recalculate and read that vector length right away. However, in my previous geometry gem, where we calculated the length of vectors, I wrote this function called vector length that takes 1 input vector and returns its length, which I kind of like. So I'm going to reuse that. So I just copied that. I pasted that function here. Okay. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to use that function. So vector length, and then I'm going to pass vector v, and that is going to give me the length of that vector. All right. And then what I'm going to do now is I'm going to calculate each one of the coordinates of the new unit vector coordinates. So what I'm going to do is wux, I'm going to call it vx, and that's going to be whatever the coordinate of the x was divided by that length that I just calculated. Then I'm going to say vy is going to be the original y coordinate of the original vector divided by the length of that vector. And then vz is going to be the coordinate z of the original vector divided by that length. So now I have those three coordinates. But remember that what I want to return is actually a vector object. So now create a vector object in Rhino Common, which is what the geometry kernel for Grasshopper is, we have a class called Vector3D that we can use to create vectors. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new variable called unit vector, which is going to be a new vector. I'm going to construct a new Vector3D object. And then the coordinates are going to be those coordinates that I just calculated, Vx, Vy, and Vz. And then I'm going to output that through the component, which is called VUnit, was the output, is going to be unit vector. That new vector that I just created over here. So let's see if this works. So I'm going to generate that, okay? And then I'm going to compare these two, and it looks like they are pretty identical, so that's great. I'm going to, so that's pretty good. And just to double check, this is the vector length script that I did in my previous geometry gem when we were calculating lengths of vectors. So I'm going to plug that in here, and you can see that it tells me that this unit vector has a length of 1. So that's great. So it looks like things work. And then if I modify any of the input components, you can see that the vector changes, but the length is still always being 1. Can you see that on the screen? Yes, you can see that on the screen. Okay, so that was unitizing a vector, super simple. Remember, the way to unitize a vector is to create a new vector which has coordinates equal to the original ones divided by the length of the original vector. As simple as that, okay? Now, we have learned how to do this the manual way, and you know me already. This is probably something that we want to perhaps abstract into a function. So I would want to do something like, for example, creating here a function that returns a Vector3D given a unit vector. So for example, given a Vector3D object, lowercase v is going to return another Vector3D, which is the same vector, but in a unit way, okay? And then I can just copy-paste most of this, except for this that I have to rename to lowercase v, all right? So here I can calculate the length using this function that has to be available, okay? And then I could do here, what I could do is I could say, can I calculate the unit vector of uppercase v? And that should give me the same result, except that the name V does not exist in line 72. Yes, I forgot to replace this one here. So I'm going to replace that one there. And then it's still not working. Because I forgot to return the vector actually. So return unit vector. All right, and now it works. And it's a unit vector, and this is the same numbers. So that's great. So now we have this in a form, which is a function that we can reuse and share between different parts of our code. Now, this is the manual way of unitizing a vector, but for those of you who are Rhino and Grasshopper users, you may want to learn the way to do this with Rhino Common, which is, for example, this is going to be the manual way. And here, I'm going to say the Rhino Common way. And the Rhino Common way is doing the following. So the Rhino Common way is we can take the vector v, and then we can unitize it. And there is a function that lives inside of vectors. And then what this is going to do is that it's going to take vector v, and it's going to unitize it in place. In place means that it's not going to return a new vector that is now a unit, the way we have done it in our function, but it's going to take the vector v and it's going to modify that vector, okay? So we're going to lose, in a way, the original vector for this new unit one. So it's a slightly different behavior, and the pros and cons is that maybe it's faster and a bit more memory efficient, but we also lose, if we will, the original data. So if we ever need to go back to the original coordinates for whatever reason, we can't do that because we have actively changed this vector. So that's one way to see it. The other way to see it is that if you look at the Rhino Common way, when I open UnitDice, you can see that this function actually returns a Boolean and instead of returning a new value. Why is that? It returns a Boolean because not all vectors can actually be unitized. Let me show you an example of that. So for example, I'm going to create a variable called success, and it's going to be equal to the result of whatever happened here. If success was false, then I'm going to display a message here. This component at runtime message, grasshopper runtime message level error, and that's going to be cannot unitize vector. All right. So let me show you this. Okay. So for example, let's say that I'm going to run this code, and right now I haven't. So v unit is going to be equal to this new vector v that I just unitized, right? And you can see that right now it's working and it's giving me the same result. But if I now take all the coordinates of this vector and I zero each one of them, all of them together, then guess what's going to happen? I get here an error that says cannot unitize this vector. And why is that? Well, if you think about it, a vector that is a zero, zero vector that has no length or no direction whatsoever cannot be unitized because the result has infinite solutions, if you will, because the vector could be pointing anywhere, because it's not pointing anywhere really. It doesn't have a direction. That is the geometric interpretation. If you want the mathematical interpretation, if you look at the algorithm for unitizing a vector involves dividing each one of the coordinates by a number, the length of the vector. It turns out that if this length happens to be zero, then we know that dividing a number by zero is an indeterminacy. It's a calculation that cannot be done, that returns infinity or other kinds of. So that cannot be computed, and therefore there's no solution to that operation. That is why the Rhino Common function doesn't really return a vector. What it returns is a Boolean flag telling us if we did successfully unitize that vector or not, if it was possible. Okay. All right. Cool. So that was vector unitization, or I don't even know how to call that, both the manual way and the Rhino Grasshopper way. Remember, unitizing a vector is just as simple as taking each one of its coordinates and dividing them by the length of the vector and creating a new vector with those divided coordinates. Just as simple as that. All right. Beautiful. With that, I think that's what I wanted to get to today. Thank you very much. If you found this video useful or entertaining or learning, you learned something, maybe you want to consider liking the video, subscribing to the channel, maybe turning on notifications to see when we go live, when we publish new videos, etc., etc. And in the meantime, I'll see you in any other of the videos in this channel. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.